from either side of the country. It's like we're previously indifferent to each other, but then, whoa, we're on the internet. Whoa. Fear not. Clown, other clown, behold the realm of chat realm. Oh, it's the true origin story live of Bri and the Gerbs. Welcome to Night Attack, bringing you the best and the worst of the internet ever since 1776. Hello, beautiful people. I'm Bri Rushwood, live in Austin, Texas, joined all the way from the western coast of the far western sea in Westeros. It's gotta be Justin Robert Young. What is up, JR? Why?
Oh, sorry, man. You caught me doing my kung fu moves.
Yeah, dude. Was that a dance? I thought that was your bit. Was you had to explain how this was a dance, but those were just straight up sweet moves.
Yeah, well, you know, things are getting a little rough out here.
Oh, you have to defend yourself against the homeless?
I mean, there's a lot of honor being impugned, a lot of disrespect happening amongst the streets.
Well, I mean, give me an example. When's the last time you got disrespected?
Well, you know, so I was walking down the street today. I was going to drop off some mail, and this guy, old guy, just yells at me. Says, "Your butthole's hanging out."
Oh, jeez, that's very specific. Like, was that maybe a code word for something?
I thought initially. Well, first I checked my butthole, right? Because I was like, because that's, we've all been there.
You were afraid, like, you had sneezed and accidentally prolapsed, like, a good foot and a half.
You forgot to zip. And
how? Maybe you and I are built differently. My tubing stops at the exit door. I'm not.
You're not down with two zipper jeans.
Okay. Question. Time out.
Yeah.
Let's say I'm not gonna say you had to do it forever, but yeah. The genie shows up and says, "Listen, you can experience a trunk-like prolapsed intuberance that comes out your backside.
Okay.
It won't be forever. It'll just be for 1 week. You can just try it on, and for 1 week, and then I'll snap my fingers, and it'll go back to normal. Do you take him up on it?"
Wait, for what? Like, what do I get if I do
this? You get the experience! You get the experience of doing the double. You have a zipper in front, a zipper in back, and when you go number two, you could go number two standing up. And you zip and flop out, and you could do it in the urinals. And then when everyone's like, "Who pooped in the urinal?" You're like, "It was me, because I can do it standing up."
I guess you could just kind of like whip your tail around and wash it in the sink.
Well, yeah. Dude, you would have the cleanest backside of all.
Yeah.
So,
you
I mean, just for one week.
Like, you would feel like that there was a bridge too far when it went back to the normal way, right?
Well, yeah. It's like imagine, like, you know what? You'd feel like, "I used to be a double man. Now I'm half woman," because there's only where there was a protuberance. Now
that
there's,
seems like a Disney song from the 90s that would happen in like the middle of the first act, like I used to be a double man.
So is that a yes or a no? Would you take the tour?
I feel like I would still need some compensation.
What? The experience is its own reward.
Sometimes I feel like you push these genie things like as if you're going to get a commission, like as if you're getting a referral code on each time.
Hey, look, I can neither confirm nor deny that I just got back from GenieCon 2016, and there were some pretty sweet incentives. By the way, my favorite genie are the blue genies. Everyone knows the blue genies are the best genies.
Yeah, I feel like you're like, "Hey, listen, all right, wait, you wouldn't do it? And when you do, you got to make sure you use offer code Scam School."
Just mention my name. Say, "My buddy Brian Brushwood warned me if I ever met a genie, I should take the free 1 week trial because there's no obligation. You experience a butthole out your backside." Not your regular
Brian, you had a hell of a day today. You and the missus went on out to do something that's sweeping the nation.
Heck yeah, dude.
Rat cocaine.
Crime. We went on a jewel heist. What's funny is we did the Austin Panic Room thing, and it's like, you know, those puzzle shenanigans.
But
it was Escape the Rooms, I believe, is the genre. The idea. So walk people through, for people who don't know what the hot hell this is.
Is basically, you get 1 hour. You're filed in 8 to 10, or I don't know, however many people, up to 10 people in there. You got a lot. And what's great is I thought the plot was going to be like, you need to stop the terrorist. You need to solve the murder. But it was none of those. It's like, you need to steal the most valuable crap in the universe in this art museum. And so you walk in, and it looks like a museum. They got art up on the walls, and you just have a bunch of stuff that's locked. And then you got to figure out, like, how to unlock everything with codes. And then you get, like, a limited number of clues and all that stuff. It was a blast, man. I really dug it.
So we're joined, of course, by the invisible wife, Bonnie Brushwood.
Hello.
Bonnie, what did you think? Did you learn anything about yourself or Brian or your marriage while trying to steal this art together?
I did. It was awful.
What?
I did.
Oh, look at that. Brian just skating over the truth.
I thought we had a wonderful experience.
No, we did.
Oh, well.
Didn't listen,
Brian,
to the question.
Before Bonnie goes, what would you suspect is awful?
I suspect that Bonnie felt like, okay, here's what I think it is. It's, if Bonnie was going to speak in plain English, she was like, I was supposed to be the smartest one who knew all the answers, and it turns out I didn't know all the answers.
Oh, man, you totally nailed it.
And every time somebody who wasn't me had an answer, I was like, well, this trip sucks.
No, it wasn't like that. It wasn't like the experience was awful. What I learned about myself was awful. What I learned is that, like, I found something to do, and then I just kept doing that even though it wasn't going anywhere. And then I was just like, but I'm looking busy. And
yeah, unfortunately, like, Bonnie's contribution was, have you tried hitting it? Yeah, we're all trying to solve puzzles, and Bonnie's literally punching works of art all around us.
No, and I'm like, I'm
over
a doer.
Her head, like, so it's just the frame around her shoulders, and you
know. she bangs in like, I'm the Mona Lisa. Ooh, ooh, ooh. We're like, Bonnie, that's not
look
helping.
At my smile.
It's like the opening scene in Goonies. She's put the lips on there, and she's sticking her tongue through the painting like.
So Bonnie, did you melt down? You couldn't figure it out?
No. I mean, like, I just found myself, like, I figured. There's, like, this one that was, like, half open, and there was a key right there, and I was just,
oh,
like...
Oh, yeah. Bonnie's biggest contribution was when she goes, like, I have the last piece of the poster that tells us the next code. I was like, well, where did you get it? She's like, I used this paintbrush to wedge it in the crack and pull it out. I was like, wait, so we're getting the clues out of order? And she goes...
So Bonnie, you just like by way of forcing something, like, just got another clue?
Yeah, I was like, it's all fair, right?
But it's not helpful.
Technically it is. I mean, like, the game should be built so people can go out of order.
Well, and we heard, and okay, so we finished, spoiler alert, we won. We solved it with like five and a half minutes to spare.
And how many people... Like, I saw there was a percentage, right? How many people...
When we went into the room, only 36% had a solve rate of 36% on time. And so we made it, you know, we made it. And we're like, ho-ho, guess who is a badass? It's us. We're badasses. And
by the way, how many times or how much do you think is that them, like, just, like, faking the orgasm and being like, oh, my God, no one ever solves this room.
Well,
you
that's the problem.
So smart.
That's the problem is because we finished the room and then we all laid back and we all asked our proctor to tell us how great we were in bed. And so we're like,
she was the worst.
Oh, no, she was great because she told the truth. We're like, ha, so how great are we? And I'm like, what's the easiest room here? And she's like, probably this one. It's probably the easiest. And I was like, we just found out we were adequate.
That's how they get you
in,
man. You know, listen, you're going to do the next room that's like the art thief's den, and then you'll do the next one, which is like the Rothschild conference, you know, like steal a watch, and then next thing you know, you're in Scientology.
They have a room called the prison where it's like they're separated into two rooms, and half of them, or everybody starts handcuffed. and then you have to solve a puzzle to get the key to unlock the handcuffs and all this stuff. So I don't know. That's the brilliant thing is, you know, once you write this story, you know, it's scalable, and I really dug it. I'll probably go back and do it again. That would be a good thing to do next year for the South by Southwest crowd.
Oh yeah, it was totally fun.
Say that you decided you wanted to make your own panic room.
Oh, dude, let's write the chat realm panic room right now. Yeah.
What would be? Because yours was you had to steal art, right?
Well, yeah. Well, and what's funny is, and this is the one part that I felt totally stupid, is that our task was to number one. The idea was somebody had broken in, but he was foiled, and so we're sent in to finish the job. We have 1 hour to, number one, figure out what he was trying to steal, and number two, get out. And, you know, you walk up, and it's like there's an exit door that definitely has, you know, three padlocks on there, and you get the codes, and you are escape from the room. But the question of, like, well, how do you know what it is we're supposed to do? And so it's like you get into this box, and you get clues to open up this lock to get in another box, and you solve this, and you get a key. And then at some point, and I'm like, oh, we got this crate open. And it's like, oh, this ancient head of a statue is worth $8 billion and blah, blah, blah. And it's like, great. And then and they're all like, okay, now we just got to escape. And I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't know that we're supposed to figure out what the thing to escape with is. And then there's this pregnant pause with like seven people staring at me like, how about the thing that clearly says it's worth $8 billion? And I was like, oh yeah, no, I guess we got it. We'll take this thing.
It wasn't the last thing we were able to open because it's a linear game.
I'm sorry. So picture me surrounded by 75 open boxes, open up the 80th box, and then be like, well, I don't know, guys. Says it's worth $8 billion. Are we sure this is what we're supposed to steal?
Like, but where's the body? You know, like we could admit, I mean, if this is where they bill, like, you know, like what's that torso going to go for?
So what would the goal be of a chat realm panic room? It would have to be to
escape a whorehouse without a TD.
Wait, what?
Number one, considering some of the social anxiety of our crowd, it might be just talking to a stranger that you've already met once online. That would be the answer.
Maybe it's like to derail. Well, you know what'd be great is the number one challenge is you walk into the room, and then on the video screen is you and me doing pre-show. We have a recorded like 90-minute track, and there's pre-show, and we're getting ready, and it's like you have to solve the riddle to call in to derail the show. It's like there's a secret code word that'll break the show. And that was one great moment in this whole thing is we're a lot of art related clues, and there's even some history books like we had to figure out a certain date based on history, and so we would go look it up. But then you open up this cabinet and there's a laptop in there, and then we realize there's some other thing. There was a USB key, and we put it in, and we're watching security footage of the guy doing the attempt last night. Anyway, but maybe they have to interrupt and call in live to derail our show. And then at which point they do, and it plays like a recorded scripted event.
Somebody says you have to get out or get brodied. Like there's
when you run out of time.
Yeah.
You have to tell some story involving your underpants in 30 seconds, or you get brodied, and that'll be the key is that we'll be on call 24/7 while it's going on.
It turns out this is our actual hell. Like we have to do this show constantly forever for four people at a time.
Well, listen, I think that's super awesome. That kind of attraction is super, super popular. And I don't know if this is still in the works, but if there are Indianapolis chat realm or Diamond Club fans or people who are going to be in Gen Con this year, huge tabletop and card game conference in Indianapolis, Indiana, the contender will be having our unofficial event all through the convention at the Escape the Room, like a block from the convention center.
Oh, right on.
Really?
So if you are doing it, if you're coming out to Gen Con, come on out. We'll be there. You play the contender. You do the escape room. It's super rad. So if there's any Diamond Club Gen Con folk, then put that on your calendar.
So what about you, man? What's your last week look like?
Oh, man. Lots of stuff.
You woke up, went to bed like 5-6 times.
Oh, man, I was getting sleep. Man, Man, you ever been out here getting sleep?
Is that, I'll cut you.
I be getting sleep, yeah. Where my fellas at getting sleep? Yeah. 8-9 hours sleep. Man, sometimes I be sleeping so much I wake up and I'm like, huh? I be sleeping every night on pillows, blankets, sleeping.
Now you're just bragging.
Yeah, dude. It's probably Bonnie's probably not the best audience for you to be throwing that in the face of. How many of y'all got kids? I wouldn't know. I don't have them. My birds don't go crap in their pants. They crap on the floor like they's meant to.
And I get my God.
I didn't realize. I thought I was just doing a funny little bit, and it turns out that there's like the only person that could be in the room that would just start booing and throwing produce at me.
You couldn't see it off camera, but Bonnie starts with her drink up like she's about to drink, but she pauses to laugh at your bit, and then the grin becomes a little more brittle, a little more plastic, and the wine kind of drops down 3 degrees at a time, and then the head starts to shake. And then it's finally like, you're a real asshole there, aren't you?
Like that was effectively the equivalent of me doing the Michael Richards routine, you know, for the offended parties there.
Oh my God, that's amazing.
All right, well, no, listen, my week was fairly boring. We got a bunch of really really fun contender stuff coming up, but I can't really talk about it right now, or else I'd be spoiling the joke. Let's go ahead and get into what we're going to be doing today. We have a special guest, and he will join us. It is Garrett Weinzierl of the Angry Chicken. But first, let's go ahead and talk to you a little bit about a good friend of mine, Brian.
I mean, are we going to get this real? I didn't expect we were going to get this real this early.
Just a boy, I remember in elementary school, there was a man named Edgar Patreon.
I mean, first of all, he was French. It was Patreon.
Patreon. Funny, fun fact. His father was French, but he was French-Canadian.
Right. So he was Patreon.
Patreon. Patreon.
He had
yeah,
the...
No, you had
Patreon.
But, yes. You know, when he was around, he was always so nice, which was odd because he sounded like a weird Edward Robinson villain.
Could you say Edward Robinson villain?
Edward G. Robin, who is the meh? See?
Okay. All right. I'll take your word on that one. I don't know. But anyway, well, he died. He died on the... He died on the Titanic. A lot of people don't know this.
A lot of people don't, but he was actually the cause of it. He was so busy fulfilling people's dreams that he was just like distracting the crew, and he was like saying like, would you like a dog? I will give you a dog. And then a dog appeared. He was a magical person. I just gave him magical powers, therefore wrecking the tenets of the story, because apparently no one said, hey, I'd like to not die in the ocean. That happened. He died, but in his stead, there was a website erected.
Well, it was a bit of a memorial, and a few people have chiseled their names upon that memorial to be remembered for time in memoriam.
Horizon makes the correct, and this might have been lost to history, but some people say that Edgar Patreon actually, it's not that he didn't hear anyone wishing to not die. He heard the singular wish of the iceberg itself.
And you know what? He loved nature. Edgar Patreon.
Oh, man, he did. He loved it. He was just like, I will grant the wish of this towering natural beauty. And he died. Everyone in the Titanic died. Hey, RIP, big ups, mad love.
That's what they said at the service, if I remember. I was there.
In spirit. So what happens is they set up this website, patreon.com, in honor of him and everything that he did. And you can support us right there. Just head on over, patreon.com/nightattack. and you can support this show.
Hey, can I do a new bit that I got?
Do a new bit?
Yeah.
Do a
new bit. It's called Freak Out, One Person Who's Probably Jogging Right Now.
Okay.
Sup, Daniel McClellan?
Oh, no!
What are you up
Daniel
to?
Daniel McClellan?
Daniel McClellan. Dude, I mean, I was just sitting here thinking that you, right now, we are experiencing through time and space, we are connected, you and me, Daniel McClellan. I'm only thinking of you, and you're only thinking about the fact that I'm thinking of you, even though this happened in the past. Daniel McClellan.
Yeah.
You just got freaked out.
Listen, if you're Daniel McClellan, take a picture of yourself freaking out right now and use hashtag I'm freaking out right now.
Yeah. If that freaked you out, Daniel McClellan, let me know. By the way, thank you for your pledge on Patreon. That's what we're going to do. Whoever pledges, you're in the running for the old Brian freak out.
Exactly. You're never going to know how Brian's going to freak you out. Is he going to say your name? Is he going to say your name? Hey, your name.
Is he going to pretend to talk to you? He might be gossiping about you. I mean, look, you know what I like about Daniel McClellan?
Yeah.
A lot of people make a decision, and they stick with it. Not Daniel McClellan. Sometimes you make a decision, you decide, I'm going down that road. I'm like, I ain't going down it hard enough. I need to give it. He doubled his pledge.
He doubled it?
I mean, I'm sorry, Daniel, you doubled your pledge. Wait, and that's why you're amazing.
Are you just trying to bully our patrons?
No. Yeah. Daniel McClellan, you're totally awesome. You're a national hero. You're better than Edgar Patreon. Where? I forget. Was it a snort at the end or eh?
No, it's eh.
Yeah.
All right. Daniel McClellan, man, he be Helen when it comes to that Patreon. Everybody check it out. Daniel McClellan on Squarespace.
You can't just, we don't know if you are. Oh, thank you very much.
Hey, I'll tell you what. Here's a man that can sort all this out. Not only is he the host of The Angry Chicken, the number one Hearthstone podcast in the world, he is also a co-host of the Star Wars podcast, whose name I can't remember, and The Angry Nerd, his solo show. I would like to bring him to the stage right now because his vision was to do a one-day convention in Orlando called CreateCon, and it will feature not only The Angry Chicken, Into the Nexus, but also bringing everything together all up in the final slot. It will be a live episode of Night Attack. If you are in Orlando, this is a can't-miss event. Ladies and gentlemen, Garrett Weinzierl.
Woo, Garrett!
You dorks.
Dude, you look like you're teleporting in from a movie. Is that a green screen behind you? What, break this down for me. Why do you look like you're in the middle of, you're about to do battle with Doctor Who?
Well, it looks like I'm about to do battle at the Hearthstone Inn, man. Come on, you play this game. Get with it. I also brought some green screen swag for the show that I'm on. So there we go.
Oh, shameless pandering!
Is it working?
It is.
I also made sure they were on their own layer because I didn't know how this was going to be cut. So I can, I can really
That's
just.
Good. That's good.
I'm going to cover your face.
You know what? Let's just, less of you, more of just the Diamond Club symbols and maybe throw some boners on there as well while you're at it. 8 equals D. How you been, Garrett, man?
I've been all right. I'm excited to be on the show and not just telling a dildo story.
I mean, in all fairness, that was a pretty epic dildo story. I'm not gonna lie.
Listen, that was good enough to keep you like in everyone's good graces for months now. In between that show and this one, all right, real quick, let's go ahead and just get the details out on this before we get too far in. CreateCon is Saturday, July 30th, from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Tickets are cheap, man. They start at $42, and then for the higher end, it's like...
Time out real quick. Just to be totally fair, you might need to do a little something on your SEO, because when you search for CreateCon, can you jump back? The number one result is 3 ways to create a folder named con.
Because you can't do that on Windows. It's a blocked thing, yeah.
You're getting stomped. I mean I know a lot of people need to make folders named con.
I mean, all of my folders named Khan are spelled like the Star Trek characters. So
fair enough. Fair enough. Touché.
Never crossed my mind.
Sorry. Keep going with the details.
Cheapest is 42. It's under $80 for even the high level super VIP amazing stuff. Anything I missed there in the intro, Garrett? What made you want to put all this on?
Well, there's no Nerdtacular this year, and we all usually go to Nerdtacular, and I will be damned if I'm not going to see my friends until BlizzCon, and you two jerks don't even come to BlizzCon, so I'm doing my own thing.
Yeah, we should go to BlizzCon.
Yeah, we should also go to BlizzCon, but we're never going to go to BlizzCon. The only place you'll see us this summer will be CreateCon in Orlando. Again, that is July 30th.
How many
tickets are left?
Quite a few of the regular tickets. I think we have one VIP ticket left.
Have you guys, like, do you have a cap? Is there a point at which you can't accommodate any more people?
The venue we have is the venue that we use for our fireside gatherings, and it only accommodates up to 150 seats. So we're only accepting 150 attendees. So it's going to be a very small, very intimate con. Obviously, this is our first time doing it. We've done our fireside gatherings and we've had over 100 people there and it's been fine, but we can employ little chairs and sofas and whatnot, picnic tables. This one, since it's going to be, you know, a proper con, there's only enough space for 150 seats. So it's a pretty small.
This is one of those, like, get it now, because, like, there is a limited amount that will be available.
Yeah, so, man, wrap your mind around this. Like, you hear the legends of how, Scott Johnson's convention started off as just, let's go see a movie. And there are folks who were there. And it's like, you could be the folks who were there for the very first one of these.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, listen, man, there's I'm privy to a bunch of emails. Like, there's rumors of other fun Diamond Club people who create a podcast going. So this should be an absolute blast. Go check it out. bit.ly/createcon. bit.ly/createcon or amove.tv/createcon. All right, Garrett.
Justin.
We are happy that you are on, because when you're not ranting and raving about your dildo adventures, you create...
I want everyone to know that this doesn't involve probably what they're thinking it involves.
If you think it involves a dildo, you're right. It does. Yeah. It definitely involves a dildo.
If you think it involves Garrett smiling very wide while brandishing a dildo, then yeah, no, that's true.
I mean, I'm glad you're bringing this up. We want to get the facts straight about this.
Yeah. You do a lot of amazing podcasts, including The Angry Chicken and Into the Nexus. And I don't know if you're aware of this, but you know that the podcast awards have recently changed things up.
I have, to a certain degree. I haven't dove too far into it because we've never won one, so I don't really give a shit.
Wait, I'm sorry. Don't give. Oh! The guest won the belt. The guest won the belt. It'll be awkward when we make him spend money. Yeah.
Did anyone explain the belt to you, Garrett?
Chat room was explaining it. I figured, like, you really had to cut. Like, you really had to go for it. I didn't know PG-13 was what.
Dude, we're a family-friendly podcast. I have children, right, Garrett? Jeez.
I mean, listen, I know. Maybe from where you're from, on the west coast of Florida, it's super cool to throw dildos around and curse in front of children.
Gentlemen.
But where I'm from, on the east coast of Florida, you can only do one of those and not both.
You know what's funny? Because, like, the S word is something that everybody does. And then you would figure that dildo would be on the list way before... the S word.
Because everybody does it?
Hey, listen, man. I the rules. Take it up with the man upstairs.
Yeah, man.
Let's go ahead
in China.
And
so what am I doing? Am I, like, throwing Donald Trump $10 and making my dad
We'll
really
see.
Proud?
You just wait. We'll tell you what you're going to do, sir. But in the meantime, look, as long as we're getting political here, here's the thing. Much like alleged so-called campaign finance reform trying to dictate what you can and can't support in this U.S. America, guess what? The podcast award changed the rules. They said, you know what? no more presentation by wrestlers.
We don't want your kind. That's what they said. And and I was like, what kind? The kind of people that have won awards before and people recognize as winners of this institution's grandest prizes.
Yeah.
And we said, well, all right, guess what? Maybe we'll just have to go a different route. And so Diamond Club has taken things upon themselves. Brian, what do we have brewing here?
First of all, we, you and me, ain't got a damn thing brewing. You and me are standing there slack-jawed watching this spontaneous grassroots movement as they stand up and say, we are the 99% of the votes you're going to receive at podcastawards.com because we are the internet's first super PAC dedicated to creating one singular slate of all our favorite podcasts out of this vast constellation. This magical empire of podcasting shall reign supreme for all time and space because we have the gumption, the go-to-itiveness, the stick-up-the-buttedness to make this happen. And so they created the world's first super PAC. And if you go to diamondclub.reddit.com, you can check out hashtag hatting the system, named for the jaunty hat.
And then, of course, you can vote for which podcast you want to make our official slate at YOLO.
There's their official slate. We ain't got a thing to do. Well, look, we're journalists.
We don't have anything to do with it. Of course, super PACs, you cannot have any communication between the people that it is supporting and the super PAC itself. We have nothing. Brian, it's about time that we released an official statement. Garrett, you need to get in on this too.
Ladies and gentlemen, I understand.
Okay, I'll be the reporter and then I'll also be part of it.
Okay, that's great.
Excuse me.
Yes, you in the goofy outfit.
Yeah. Why are you so fat?
I'm working real hard. I ride my bike a lot every day.
Follow-up question. Do you have anything to do with the super PAC that is plugging your podcast for the podcast awards?
Yeah, okay, look, I it's tough to cut out the beer because it's just part of the ritual. It's what we do. And it's like I've eliminated carbs and animal products. And it's just, you can only eat lettuce for so long. Next question.
Follow-up. But what about the super PAC?
Yeah, no, I bike, I jog, I played squash this morning.
All right, this one's for Garrett. Garrett.
Why is Brian so fat?
Well, Justin, I'm glad you asked.
Just go ahead. Actually, Garrett, can you look at Brian and just say, just general, where do you think he weighs? Like, you were just going to say, like, just a general number, like, how fat do you think Brian is?
Well, without seeing what I can only assume are thunderous thighs.
Hips don't lie.
I mean, from nipples up, which is about what I'm seeing, I would guess about 185.
All right. Yes, shit just got real. I definitely just took the belt. Dude, you know what? These nips don't lie.
Oh my God. If your nips, for anybody who's listening on audio, Brian just ripped his shirt open and showed his nips. If he, in a fit of rage, just shot milk onto the camera lens, it would have been my favorite. We would have been done with the show. You can't get better than that.
It's so sexy.
All right, look, we have nothing to do with the spontaneously uprising movement. You know what? You hear about this thing called the podcast movement? That thing is a bowel movement compared to this podcast movement. This is people who listen to podcasts talking about the podcast they love the most. And if they want to get together and express their free right to speech, and if they want to click on their vote buttons and their nominations, then I, for one, support free discourse in this, the United States of our America, called planet Earth.
Brian Brushwood.
He's not
Brushwood.
Fat.
Very
He's not
slim.
Fat.
Very no. slim.
Pinches his nipples. That doesn't really work as a chant.
Listen, all right, so that's our official statement. We have nothing to do with this, but we can, just like any free citizen, peek in on what they're doing. They are transparent as an organization. We can just go ahead and look, right?
Yeah. If you go to YOLO420.com/hatvoting, You can find it. That's YOLO420.com/hatvoting. You can see. All you have to do is, I guess, log in with a Google account. Here, let me.
And you have until Sunday. So if you're listening to this on the podcast, you can probably still vote.
What is Penny's password? I want to log in. I suspect she would. I want to see if she voted. That's all I want to do.
No, absolutely. All right. So what, that was YOLO420.com/hatvoting. Slash what?
Hat voting.
Oh,
this is
sweet.
Such a delightful amount of effort put into this, by the way.
Okay, so this is what's amazing to me. This was totally organized by the community. What they're doing is they are deciding on their official slate, and to be a part of the super PAC means that you're going to vote for all the ones that the community have decided are their favorites. Let's break it down. Let's go through it. I'm looking right now. Under the arts category, they have two choices. They have the Beerists podcast or the Major Spoilers podcast. Do you have a dog in this fight, Justin? What about you, Garrett?
I haven't listened to the Beerists, so I'm going to go with Major Spoilers.
I'll go with Major Spoilers as
you know,
well.
I'm going to go Beerists because they're local boys. We got that's right here in Austin. That's Friends of the Rage Select program.
I mean, of course, we don't. Because we have no control over any of this.
When I say I mean the hypothetical I. If
the royal we.
If I was Penny Brushwood, who would I be voting for the first choice? Penny Brushwood, I assume, is a bigger fan of the Beerists podcast. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, listen, she is Austin strong and a proud supporter of her local arts.
Comedy, of course, this program is not eligible for, Justin, because we won. Wait, not in comedy.
No, not in comedy.
Not in comedy. No, we won mature and video. Right.
Yeah.
But.
Well, we're not allowed to win any this year.
No.
Because we won one. We won two last year.
Is in the mature category.
Yes, exactly. That's 100% correct.
Wonderful.
We got the Giz Whiz and Tell It Anyway. I'm going to say number one. I love you, Jenny, but I got to stand behind my boy Chad with the Giz Whiz.
And I'm going to go with. I'm just watching somebody make votes here. They're named Gertrude, and Gertrude is voting for Tell It Anyway.
What about you, Garrett?
I mean, I'm contractually obligated, since I do a Star Wars podcast with Jenny Josephson, to vote for Jenny Josephson, and everyone else should as well.
Mm. All right. Entertainment. We got four contenders. Diamond Dialogue. I mean, they have four contenders. The Diamond Dialogue, the Geek.io Show, my so-called 8-Bit Life, and We Have Concerns. Man, I hate to say it. That's kind of a no-brainer. I'm going to do first place to We Have Concerns.
Yeah. You know, I feel like Kanad is going to just have to give that one to his child.
I was about to say, I'm pretty sure he had a child just for the sympathy vote. So he's going to win this just because he's now about to have a kid.
Yeah.
Now, by the way, listen. Garrett, I don't know if you knew this, but you are going to now have an opportunity.
Yeah, apparently. I'm now noticing that the Angry Chicken and Into the Nexus are in here, and Pixels, which I'm on often enough to care.
So this is Games and Hobbies.
Yep.
I mean,
The Angry Chicken, Boop, Core, Critical Hit, DLC, The Gamers In, Dude Soup, Dueling Reviews, Into the Nexus, Le Rendezvous, Geo.
I talked to Overcast,
Pixels, and Rage Select.
I was in the room with Dan Benjamin on a conference call with Jeff Cannata, and I promised them that I would vote for DLC. And then I got a phone call from Jeff over at Rage Select saying, "Hey, I see that there's a super PAC. Will you pledge your allegiance to me?" And I said, "Absolutely. I will do whatever it takes." And it turns out I'm a bit of a liar because I'm definitely picking Angry Chicken.
Oh.
Yes.
Gertrude is as well. Gertrude really feels that the Angry Chicken deserves a podcast award. So here, let's real quick, we'll burn through the rest of these here because we got other elements. I mean, theoretically, the pack has other elements to get to. Kids and Family, Department of Parenting and Hypothetical Help. The Mature Podcast, DKG Welp, The Jury Podcast, or The Ritual Misery Podcast. Music.
Oh, dude, yeah, no, I'm voting for Jury. He's ineligible through Night Attack. Might as well make it on his solo venture.
Music, Holly Juku and Joe and Meg's Musical Adventure.
Current Geek has your friend of mine, Tom Merritt. and
News and Politics, Current Geek, Good Enough, and Politics, Politics, Politics.
Oh, shoot. No, I'm sorry. Politics, Politics, Politics.
Goddamn right.
Science and Medicine, This Week in Science, Universe Today, and Weird Things.
I've heard good things about this Weird Things program.
Society, The Phileas Club, and Two Nerdy Black Guys.
Oh, man. I don't know either. You know what? I'm not going to vote. And you know what? I am going to vote. Even though I've never listened to Two Nerdy Black Guys, it feels more diverse to click on that one.
Sports and Recreation, the Fanny Pack Wrestling Podcast, and the Mat Men Podcast.
I don't have a dog in that fight.
I'm actually wearing a Mat Men Podcast t-shirt.
All right, so then I'm going to click on Mat Men.
I mean, Gertrude. Gertrude.
Gertrude is. Yeah, Gertrude
just
is.
Slides off the bench thinking about the Mat Men Podcast. Technology, the Gizwiz, Hack 5, Le Rendezvous Tech, No Silicast, Tech Thing, and Tech in Trade. And then finally, TV and film, cinematography, Court Killers, No Pink Spandex, The Novelization Realization Project, / Film Class, Small Screen Spoiler Show, This Week in Trek, and the TV Dudes.
Done and done and done. I voted. Court Killers seems to be a good program. Okay, and I guess the deal is those who participate in the Super PAC, which again, we don't have anything to do with. This is a spontaneous uprising for people who care about podcasts.
Yes.
It sounds like those people are going to pledge to vote in a block as one unified front, the most powerful Super PAC in all of podcasting happening right here in a chat room near us.
So, like... Have you heard about a thing that happened with some of the super PACs? There was a Ted Cruz super PAC, right? And what they did to get footage of Ted Cruz in a Ted Cruz super PAC ad was Ted Cruz recorded a bunch of shots, and then the raw video was posted to YouTube. Word got back that to the super PAC, God knows how, that all this raw footage was up on YouTube. They pulled it down and edited it into commercials.
Swear to God, tell me this is real. Tell me this is factually true.
I'm not joking.
Oh, this sounds like a fun thing for the internet to have.
So I would like to just say, we're done talking about this super PAC.
Now let's do our new segment, just rapping about stuff.
Exactly, right? So if
here, let me. May I begin? I've got something I want to get off my chest. I've been thinking about this for a while. I'm going to take a moment to collect my thoughts and then look right into the camera and tell some truth.
Yeah.
I care about podcasts. Just wanted to say that. I just felt like that needed to be out there.
That's really, really good. Let me go ahead and just, again,
God,
I mean,
damn it.
As long as
Gambling Man says
here,
off your fat chest.
They're all just here. I'm so sorry. They're all just here. Let me just say something. I want to say something. I care about you.
Garrett, you got anything you want to get off your chest? Your fat chest?
I do. I firmly believe in whatever it is you believe in.
So if we were going to have, I mean, just randomly, of course, if we were going to have a slogan, right, that would encapsulate what we all feel about podcasts and voting and awards, like just randomly.
All right, I feel like if there's something we could all agree with, it's that it's not just everyone's internet, it's your internet.
Yeah. Or they'll never give it to you. Take it from them.
Or better yet, if they won't let you have it, let them have it.
Yeah. How about rob them? Rob them for everything they have. They don't want you to win, so we win.
This is sounding very night attackish. Like,
like we're actually attacking somebody
attacking,
in the night.
Yeah. Attack someone in the evening
Sneak
time.
Sneak in the dead of night and rob them for everything that they have taken from you for years. For years, you've been an underclass citizen because they put their boots on your neck, slice their throats, and drink their blood.
The podcasters are getting too pump, 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 pump. Holy cow.
Anyway, so Garrett, if you want to toss anything in there, you know, like, you know, we're all just talking.
I mean, you're talking a lot about throat slitting, and now I want to ask for you know, somebody who, as a pirate, probably has done a few. I want to ask for Captain Morgan's.
Oh my gosh! Is there a chance we can get an appearance from the captain?
I don't know. Brian, why don't you talk a little bit about the captain?
Oh man, I feel like I saw the captain around here. Maybe
he's around. He likes to live in a box.
Look where I'm pointing.
He lives in a box lately, and like he always lives in a box, but he's got like a new box.
He's in the box of your mom's box. Oh, that's where he lives. Oh, it's a freaking apartment in there.
Oh wow. Mom.
That's the kind of thing Captain Morgan would say. I of course do a lousy impression of Captain Morgan.
You do. Oh wait, I think possibly on the line.
Wait, hold on. There's a satellite connection. There's like a. Oh wait.
Ahoy!
Oh my gosh, Captain Morgan.
It's me, Brian. It's Captain Morgan.
Oh my gosh! What have you heard about what the fans of this podcast are doing? They apparently are organizing.
Brian, I'm running it. This is my boat now. I am the captain. Remember when the black guy said that to the big?
Wait,
where
what?
Where are you captaining this boat to, Captain Morgan?
We're taking it all the way to Windtown, baby.
to
love to win. My name's Captain Morgan.
It sounds like you're taking a page out of somebody else's playbook, but you're just talking about how much you like to win.
No, I'm taking it out of your mom's playbook. That's what I called a vagina. I don't know why. Because on the second fold, it was always pay dirt. Hello.
All right, Captain Morgan, real quick.
X-22 right. X-22 right. Captain's jizz.
I don't know what I just missed.
Football play.
I want to know, Captain Morgan, I mean, I'm not sure if you're involved with the pack or not, but if you could vote in the games and hobbies.
I am. I'm very involved in the pack.
So which podcast?
I'm Little B from the pack.
In game hobbies.
Well, first, all right. You wanted number one. I'm allowed to vote, unlike you.
Wait, why can't Garrett vote?
Well, because he's in it. You can't communicate. The fact that we're communicating right now ruins this whole bit. But I don't care. I'm above the law.
Oh my gosh!
So here's who I would vote for, in this order. Number one, the Gizwiz.
Okay, put him away. He's drunk.
Yeah, wait.
Number two, no agenda.
It's not even on the list. It's not on the slate. You're supposed to run this thing. You don't even know what's on it?
Number three, Mac Break Weekly.
No, they're not eligible. They're on a totally different network. The pack would never vote for these.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was confused. Oops.
Okay, so who would you vote for
then?
Number
four, Infowars.com. Ryan, I've been learning a lot from Infowars.
Oh, what have you learned?
I learned that the Rothschilds. Also, I learned about Donald Trump.
Right.
He's a real great guy.
Yeah. Okay.
I used to know him.
Wait, I'm sorry. Did you work with Donald Trump? Where did you meet?
He worked for me.
Wow. When was this?
You captained Donald Trump?
It was Trump. Might have been his surname at the time. In that he used to say, "Sir, I'm Donald Trump."
How old was he back in this time?
Oh, he was no more than 400 years old.
And so what did
he's
do?
He's immortal. Did you not know that?
One day,
Donald Trump was born in a cave by way of a shell and the blood of an Irishman.
And so did he crew on your boat?
He did. He was the coxswain.
And how good of a coxswain was
jokes.
He? How big of a coxswain was he?
I'll tell you what, with those tiny hands, you can't even tell. Stroke, 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 so fast, LOL.
At what point did you have to kick him off the ship?
Well, you know, it was a very simple situation. The captain was like, "Hey, Donald, why are you always singing Melissa Etheridge songs? She's also an immortal." He was like, "Well, come to my window." And I was like, "Well, get out of here. I don't like it. I'm more into Sarah McLachlan myself."
Is Sarah McLachlan immortal?
No, she's just a freak bitch.
All right. So I feel like you kind of are burying the lead. Do you have a list? Do you know who is and is not immortal?
Well, just name me names. I'll let you know. Name me names and I'll tell you no lames.
Sure. Bill Cosby.
Mortal.
What's that?
Mortal, not immortal.
He's mortal. Mortal.
Yeah, he's immoral. Have you seen that guy?
Okay, right. What about
what about a freak? What a weirdo that guy.
What about
Tupac?
Yeah.
Tupac, he's dead.
So mortal.
Yeah, well, no, Brian. It's the whole goddamn point of being immortal.
All right. I'm just making sure we're on the same
sorry.
Page. Elvis. Elvis Presley.
Elvis Presley, dead as a doornail.
You
ever seen a doornail?
No.
Well, it doesn't run for president now, does it? It's dead as hell.
No, that's true. All right, look, Captain Morgan, we got to get back to our highly charged political debate. Where can people where can people support whatever their cause is?
Oh, well, hey, of course, go ahead on over to YOLO420.com/hatvoting or visit me at my personal site, CaptainMorgan.info/pussypics.
I'm
leaving. Bye.
Oh my god! Everybody,
I
if
swear
you go,
to
if
freaking
you go,
god,
if you go to CaptainMorgan.info/pussypics, it takes you straight to the Captain Morgan site.
I swear to God,
it does. US.CaptainMorgan.com. That's amazing.
I have a feeling. No matter what you type after the slash will work, but no, nonetheless.
I mean, what are you gonna? You're gonna take this away from me too? What's with you, Garrett? You're killing
yeah,
me.
And you can't take the sky.
I'm sorry, I had to do the Egg Your Chicken tonight. I had to put on my logic cap, which kills fun. I have to look at cards that are clearly fun but terrible for any competitive play,
yeah,
and
real,
I have to
real
take
quick,
a dump.
I don't want to get all the way into Hearthstone Land, but what's the hot biz? What are people arguing about over in Hearthstone Land?
I don't care. I'm just excited about Shaman. This is going to be the year of Shaman, everyone.
Why is that? Because he's been a last place loser up until now? He's been a joke? Everybody laughing at Shaman?
Pretty much, yeah.
They call him Old Ramen Shaman.
Getting some sweet-ass cards is what they're...
Limp-ass noodle. That's what that guy's got.
Or a limp-ass noodle.
Man, this is... I feel like we've learned a lot about this super pack, you know? I feel like we're on a real trajectory here. Not us, but of course the movement itself. Right. This is going to be a great time. Garrett, any final pleas to the people for your shows or just a call to action?
Let's be honest. Okay, everyone out there loves Hearthstone. Chances are you listen to the show. You listen to Angry Chicken. I'm going to get some real talk right here. And have a lot of people tweeting at us. In the chat room, wonder why the F we haven't had a card reveal. And we didn't get a card. Oh. So make us win so we get a damn card next time.
Yeah. I don't know what any of that meant, but it sounds like you were wronged. And I think...
Hold on. Wait. All right. Hold on. And let's get into this for a second.
Oh, no. I don't want to know.
I've been wondering that, like, a show... All right. So just for those of you who don't know, there's a big, gigantic new expansion coming out for Hearthstone. We're not going to get into Hearthstone, but just you got to understand the context to this to understand the story. And so Blizzard,
yeah,
because what they want to do is just sell a lot of these packs. They're doing like a big special on packs. They're running for like, what has this been, like 6 weeks of like a drip feed of like showing one card here, one card there by the end of it?
They've been debuting cards themselves, and they've also been using the community. Popular streamers and personalities within the Hearthstone community, they each got a card, and they like go up against four other streamers, and whoever gets the most votes gets to reveal their card first.
So streamers?
streamers Logs. And casters and oh yeah, podcasters.
Has there been another podcast that's gotten one?
Yes, as a matter of fact.
What?
Who?
Well Met.
What do you want to do? Find the guy? Get him?
No, we like Well Met. We had one of their guys on the other day.
Wait, Well Met got one?
What's that?
Well Met got one?
Yeah, Well Met got one. Yeah, I mean they're part of BlizzPro, which is a massive effing website, so I'm not surprised there.
Now,
and this is not me. This is not me saying that we don't get love from Blizzard, because God knows we do. This is me saying that if you like the Angry Chicken, you want to see us get card reveals, be vocal about it. Go vote for us in the podcast awards. Let you know, at Play Hearthstone, at the community team, let them know that you want to see card reveals on our show.
Garrett, how familiar are you with this show?
I am. I'm pretty familiar. So that's why I'm being really fucking careful about what.
No more he
is. This also means that I can say fuck as many times as I want until someone else fucking curses.
You can. You can. All right? I'm not going to say that says a lot of good things about you, but you can do whatever you want.
You're from Florida.
Let me, East Coast of Florida, watch your mouth.
I've been to the East Coast. It's terrifying.
Yeah. All right. Let's not make this an East Coast, West Coast thing. Now, you understand, Garrett.
Yep.
That you are very popular on the show. People love you. They're already charmed by you. If they're fired up about the fact that the Angry Chicken doesn't get a card, then they're going to go find a destination for them to say that the Angry Chicken should get a card. And if you don't give them an appropriate one, they will probably find one that you will find distasteful.
Wait, I got a suggestion.
What's your suggestion?
Hashtag Bok in all capitals.
Oh wait, hold on, wait. I don't know if I got it. Bonnie, can you say it again?
Hashtag Bok.
Okay. That's gonna be someone's ringtone.
Is Brian's mic down?
Yeah, Bonnie's muted.
Your cough button.
Oh.
Oh, my mic is down. Yeah, there we go. Sorry. Yeah, no, I had a cough.
Thought there was a third random person in the room.
That's fine. It's probably for the best.
Garrett, I'm just saying, you gotta give them a destination. Give them somebody, right? On Twitter, people can say the Angry Chicken needs a card reveal.
The Hearthstone account at Play Hearthstone. Let them know. It's definitely not going to work for this one. Just so you know, if you think we're going to magically get a card for this upcoming reveal, it's just not going to happen.
Oh, Garrett, I don't know if you know what you are doing here. It's like Justin is saying, what's a safe, like you have a PVC pipe filled with liquid plasma reaching dangerously high pressures.
And that's
what's
why I'm pointing you at,
what's a place that you
want to
point it? And he says, I don't know, how about the official Hearthstone account? At which point you pull back the fire hose and blast Hearthstone in the face. Are you kidding me?
Brian, do you know how these, like, how Twitter works if you're on a video game team? That is the safest place to point them. If you're telling me I have to point them somewhere, that's the safest place to point them.
Oh, that's the one place you know for sure nobody will listen to anything they have to say.
That is the faceless.
What Garrett's saying is that you have no power. Chat realm, you don't have the pull.
Stop listening to Justin.
Reply. Hashtag Bok.
No, chat room. I do not want to give Hearthstone a
Bok. Bok. Bok.
Podcast awards voting. That'd probably be a good place to go.
White hot flame.
Hey, listen, man, this box out of the barn, at Play Hearthstone, hashtag Bok.
Dude, just flood. Take a look at the, at, was it Play Hearthstone? I'm going to guarantee you it's nothing but hashtag Bok. Just the angriest chickens showing up, yelling, and don't explain anything. Just go in there and just Bok, Bok, Bok.
Is it just hashtag B-A-W-K?
Yeah, dude. Just everybody bawking.
I'm running the search for it right now to see what's happening.
All right, let me get logged into my Twitter. I got something to say to at Play Hearthstone. At Play Hearthstone.
Now, Garrett, is there any possibility that maybe part of the reason why the fact that you guys didn't get a card reveal would be that you guys had a chance to go to the junket and didn't?
I would hope that wasn't the case.
That maybe they were like going to gather everybody and divvy out all the cards. And I was like, and then we got one for...
No, some of my friends who went didn't get cards to reveal. So that can't be the case. That's definitely not, it's not a one-to-one correlation, Justin.
But they're probably
blacklisted,
you know,
because I was invited out to a press event and then I got so incredibly ill that I couldn't go, even though I was so fucking excited.
We already know you're the illest MF-er. We get
it. He had a license to ill. That was definitely true.
Wow.
All right, the first result's coming in.
I'm glad that it's no question at all. It's just hashtag Bach. Oh, God bless.
Dude,
why didn't I channel this into shameless self-promotion?
Let's just keep that chatter going nonstop. Just God, keep I love up it. The box.
I'm gonna Bach again.
Yeah. We should probably all retweet it, too, that, you know, we just let everybody know that what we're doing right now is going to @playHearthstone and just writing hashtag Bach or die.
Oh, God.
Oh, this is beautiful. This is wonderful. You guys have scary power. So, Justin, if you find yourself in about 6 months wondering, I wonder why Ben Brode hasn't been back on the Angry Chicken.
Amazing. Hey, man, shall we move on to a little bit of housekeeping?
Absolutely. Let's go ahead and check out Diamond Time. Diamond Time is where you were able to shout out your own projects. Just head on over to diamondclub.tv or diamondclub.reddit.com or reddit.com/r/diamondclub. Stickied right up there at the top is our Diamond Time submissions. And holy hot hell, did we have a Pier 6 brawl on Diamond Time this week. Nine projects. Which
nine.
So how about this? We begin with our top vote getter, which is High Volt Rock. Greetings, Diamond Club. A friend of mine have started a podcast dedicated to craft beer and craft liquor, whiskey, vodka, whatever's delicious. We wanted a podcast that was educational, unpretentious, and above all, fun. It was about trying new things, exploring the industry happenings, and playing half-baked games. It's called Malts in Your Mouth, and we've already done 30 episodes. Your weekly source for news, reviews, brews, and BS. We're on iTunes, SoundCloud, Pocket Cast, and Stitcher. We'd love to share a drink with you and chat on Facebook or Twitter. Cheers. Head on over to bit.ly/YOLO420MaltySwag, or that is MaltySwag. DCTV.link/YOLO420MaltySwag, or YOLO420.com/MaltySwag. Thank you very much to the Malts in Your Mouth podcast.
Next up, Time Jumper 319 says, hello, Brian, Justin, and Diamond Club. While I'm not overly active in the weekly chat, many of you know me by Time Jumper 319. I have a 5-year-old nephew, Will, who was born with only half a heart. Within the first year of his life, he had 3 open heart surgeries to try to correct it. When he was 3, he was supposed to get his final surgery to allow him to live a relatively normal life. Unfortunately, it was determined that his heart would not be able to take the surgery. Because of this, he was put on the heart transplant list. It's been 2 years, and we're hopeful that he will get a new heart this year. My brother and his wife do a t-shirt every year to raise funds to cover the expenses, because that insurances don't. If you're interested, I've included the link to their Facebook site that has the shirt order form. Thanks for your interest. Patrick, a.k.a. TimeJumper319. That's Facebook.com/TeamWillT-shirts. Team Will T and shirts are all capitalized, but the rest is not. The first letter is. Or, as California Carl points out, just go to YOLO420.com/TimeySwag.
Let me also just say, he's too modest to point it out in this, but Time Jumper is, again, the dawn of Patreon, the man who supports so many independent podcasts that when he walked into Patreon's offices in San Francisco, they stood up and gave him a standing ovation. He deserves your respect
because he's a lot of the reason why some of your favorite shows are on and are supported,
including this one, man. And as a matter of fact, he is the sole sponsor of the South by So Wasted concerts that we've done in the past. He is truly a treasure, and let's. In fact, we already know whoever wins the belt that by the time we're over here, this is definitely what they're going to be throwing money at.
Absolutely, and finally. We have IDR RBI in the Captain Morgan voice, so I'll just do my impression of Captain Morgan.
Oh, I don't think you can pull it off.
Ahoy, bitches!
ahoy, bitches. Here's another venue for chat realms to talk about anything under the sun besides IRC and Reddit. Discord, available through the web, desktop app, and iOS, Android. The text channel server there is named Asshole Clan. Hello. If you're interested, go to bit.ly/shutup. I'm not reading this for an invite. Or the better URL says yolo420.com/discord swag.
This is a pretty good impression. I feel like maybe you ever considered like on a radio show calling in as Captain Morgan?
Maybe.
Can we make that a thing? Can we do that? Can we do a bit where we call, like, find a bunch of local stations that will pretty much take anyone, get on the air, and then just keep handing it over to Captain Morgan, who has a point?
Oh, God. Like, on whether. Pop radio station. Yeah. That'd be fantastic.
Sports radio, AM talk stations, political talk, or whatever. That just he calls in and then just shows up all over and chat room collects them all into an amazing collection.
A really good supercut.
I feel like that, tell you what, we'll go ahead and put that in the pocket. See where that goes. Hey, listen, even if you, number one, support everything that we've talked about, but listen, there are nine total projects that are here in Diamond Time. They are all worth you reading. So head on over there right now, reddit.com/r/diamondclub or diamondclub.reddit.com. This is our favorite part of giving back to the community because you guys have given us so much. So check it out, Diamond Time at the Diamond Club Reddit.
I'll tell you what, no matter how much you gave to us, it's not as much as we're going to take from our enemies in the Summer Movie Draft. Let's go to the Movie Draft Minute.
Welcome to Movie Draft Minute presented by CosmicRadio.tv for the week of April 4th. 2016. I'm your host, Roberto Villegas. With no new movies out this week, nothing really changes. So let's go check the scoreboard anyways. Team Cord Killers, DTNS, We Have Concerns, and Team Night Attack are all tied for third place. Still waiting for their first film. Team M-Truckers in second place with $36.5 million. And in first place with a whopping $260.4 million. It's Team Chainsaw Suit. And that is your Movie Draft Minute for the week of April 4th, 2016.
So here's what a good buy the Chainsaw Suit boys got. That Batman vs. Superman movie is hilariously underperforming, and yet it's still an insane bargain for them.
Oh, no. Like the number to beat, and we've talked about this before, it seems like the winner tends to make about $1 billion, which means each game dollar has to yield $10 million of real money. And in this case, they've already blown past it in 1 week. Now, granted, that's pretty much all they're going to get since it saw an 87% drop week over week. Worst ever, even surpassing X-Men Origins Wolverine.
Ooh.
Just saying is all.
Which, by the way, featured Deadpool, which now has a legit chance to make more than Batman versus Superman.
Yeah.
Based on Batman versus Superman's projections.
I live in a world where that's even a frigging possibility.
Oh, yeah. Especially when this week, the number one draw in movies, Melissa McCarthy, for which we have pinned a tremendous amount on Team Night Attack.
Dude,
into the box office with The Boss.
Dude, there's already like articles legit saying that it's likely that The Boss will unseat Batman versus Superman and take the number one slot. We got it for $9. However, everybody knows there's only one thing everyone's talking about. It's hardcore Henry Fever. Everyone's catching it. That is totally worth the $24 that we spent on it.
Are you sure?
We only spent that because that was the only way that we got both that and Civil War.
I mean, it wasn't the only way. It was just us showing off, but whatevs.
Gotcha.
dude, that is, this is going to be a tight draft, man. I think this is going to be a nail biter. This is going to be a real whistler.
I agree, especially because, well, man, yeah. No, it's going to be crazy. We've got movies right up to the end. I think Secret Life. Oh, we got Secret Life of Pets. I saw an ad for that, and I was like, this movie's garbage. And then I just now looked, and I was like, I hope it makes a lot of money.
Hey, I don't know. Their Super Bowl ad was pretty good.
It was pretty funny.
Yeah, all right. It's cool.
What are you talking about? You mean the greatest movie on earth? The Secret Life of Pets?
I mean, it's I know Citizen Kane.
I mean, yeah, it's not shot in first person for the entire time and have the star of District 9, but it's a fantastic film.
Wait, is that the guy in Hardcore Henry? Is the
only recognizable face that you actually see for the whole trailer? Yeah, that's the guy from District 9.
Right on.
Well, no, and the Divergent / Fault in All our Stars girl, right? She's in it.
Haven't seen Divergent.
Well, I think it is. This is a great segment. No one knows who that lady is.
So it's Charlotte
Copley. Haley Bennett?
Who cares? Nobody cares. Nobody cares.
Charlotte Copley.
No, sure. Good old Charlotte. Something about camel toe. That's all I got. All right. Hey, where can we see more of your lovely, lovely face, Mr. Garrett?
Oh, me. Everything I do can be found over at amove.tv, including CreateCon right there at the top. And the main image is you come on the damn website. So you should go there. You should buy a ticket. You should come on down to Florida. See a live Anger Chicken. See live Into the Nexus. See a live Night Attack. And then go to Epcot and get drunk in every fake country you can think of.
Hey, man, those are real countries. They require passports, and the beer is authentic, and all the people are students who are definitely all hooking up. Mexico's definitely hooking up with England. I saw it. I seen it with these eyes.
So, I believe Anthony Carboni has funny stories of going and partying at the Epcot dorms, where apparently, like, poop does get wild.
Oh,
like,
dude. I mean, you got to imagine. It's magic. They're like, well, I'm supposed to. It's permanent spring break. And what do you do on spring break? You make
a restaurant. Now multiply that by the size of a theme park where there's multiple friggin' restaurants in multiple fake countries.
Yeah, and if you ever, like, get in trouble, like, you know, you bang these ladies and all of England's pissed off, you can abscond over to Morocco and be all like, hey, I'm waiting for the heat to die down over there. I put some fish in her chips, if you know what I mean.
Diplomatic immunity.
Diplomagic immunity? Is that what you said?
It might as well have.
That's great. Diplomagic Kingdom immunity.
Dude, so what if we did an album that was just a bootleg album that we recorded live around the world?
Our first mixtape.
Well, no, we've done several mixtapes, but we could do something.
Oh, yeah, that's right. By the way, did we release a new mixtape? I haven't heard.
We didn't have a new mixtape this week, but we'll have one coming up soon.
Yeah.
Man, this has been a hell of a program. We've irreparably damaged Garrett's relationship with Blizzard.
Yep. That hashtag Buck.
We had an amazing movement, an amazing podcast movement spring up all around us without any of our help. Is there any final words, Brian, that you'd like to leave the people with?
No, there's really not. I love you guys. We'll see you guys later on. I guess that's it. Let's roll the lullaby. It's a tight show. It's fast. We got in, we got out. Quit farting about.
No, Night Attack is through. Is there something that I did? Is there something I can do?
That's a whole lot of
box. Oh no, Night Attack is done. My heart has been broken. The depression's just begun. Ryan Brushwood, every time you leave, I wanna hurt myself by pissing off some bees. I'm allergic to bees. Oh, Justin Robert Young, every time you go, I get so sad that I wanna drink a warm glass of Drano. Night attack, night attack, night attack.
Hey guys, balking a fire.
Box next Tuesday.
Job done. Night
attack. Box done? Night what? Attack,
night attack. I love you.
Yes!
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.